beating and shouting. I'm saying, you might as well just kill me. I'm going to jail for life anyways.
2 weeks after a Manchester police officer was shot in the line of duty, we're learning a whole lot more about what happened that night. Police describe a suspect who said he would kill police if they ever tried to arrest him. Officer Dan Doherty is still recovering at a local hospital after he tried to stop a suspicious man who was said to be possibly armed. At a hearing this morning, a judge ruled that the case against Miles Webster will go toward a trial. Ray Brewer has more on the story.
Detective Patrick Houghton described what Officer Dan Doherty says he saw and felt the evening of March 21st. Doherty was responding to a report of a suspicious person, possibly armed. Houghton said when he saw someone fitting the description, Doherty gave chase. Just before he was about to tackle the man, police say Miles Webster pulled out a gun and fired, striking Officer Doherty in the leg, sending him to the ground.
Officer Doherty explained that while he was on the ground on his back, this subject continued shooting him. And that he could feel the round striking him. And as Officer Doherty was looking up, he observed that the subject actually advanced on him.
Houghton testified Doherty was able to pull out his weapon and fire 10 shots at Webster.
Officer Doherty explained that they continued shooting at each other, and he watched as the defendant began running away in a southwesterly direction towards Herman Street.
It has been reported that Officer Doherty was struck 5 times. Now Houghton says it may have been 4 times, but we're also learning more about the injuries Doherty suffered.
The bullet that entered in his left upper thigh, he described as traveling through his internal abdominal region. And while the bullet was traveling through his abdominal region, it caused a number of injuries to his intestines.
During cross-examination, defense attorney Carolyn Smith tried to sow doubt by pointing out that not all the witnesses agree with what happened or even the man they think they saw being chased by police.
She said that she saw a white male being chased by a police officer.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
And she says that she did see the gun.
Correct.
And she said she saw a silver gun.
Yes, she did.
Is that right?
Yes.
And we will have more on the developments from court starting at 5. Salem police are investigating a violent home invasion that began with men smashing their way in with baseball bats. Police say a group of 7 people went to a home on Independence Drive last night to confront a man who lived there, possibly about drugs. Fights broke out inside and outside the home. The resident grabbed a knife and ended up stabbing one of the suspects several times. One person, 20-year-old Alan Frias of Salem, has been charged with assault and burglary. Charges are also expected for at least 4 others. We know you have a lot of memories about Fenway Park, so here is your chance to share those memories as Fenway turns 100. Go to WMUR.com, upload your photos from Fenway Park to You Local, and we may just be using some of them during our newscasts on opening day next Friday, April 13th. A story just into our newsroom. State police have announced an arrest in the assault of a 2-year-old boy in Albany. The boy suffered life-threatening injuries back in December. Now police say those injuries were caused by Justin Roy. Roy will face a judge this afternoon on 2 counts of second-degree assault. We'll bring you any new information that we learn about this case starting on News 9 at 5. Thanks for joining us and have a great afternoon.